The Disney Cruise Line is truly magical in every regard. I'm looking forward to more cruises in the future, but some special itineraries have a very special theme, like Halloween or Christmas or Marvel Day at Sea. And based on a recent survey from Disney Cruise Line, it appears that Disney might be looking at adding more themed cruises in the future. Now, at the time of filming, there are currently 4 different themed cruises offered by Disney Cruise Line on very special itineraries. You have the Very Merry Christmas Cruise, the Halloween on the High Seas Cruise, the Star Wars Day at Sea, and Marvel Day at Sea. I am really looking forward to trying one of these specially themed cruises in the future. They look like a lot of fun. Some guests who recently were on those specially themed cruises were given a survey asking them if they'd be interested in different themed Disney cruises. The 10 different themes that Disney included on their survey are the Walt Disney World at Sea theme. Yes, I did say that right. Disney Broadway at Sea theme, International Food and Wine theme, Disney Music theme, Disney Animation theme, Disney Hero versus Villain theme, Mickey Mouse theme, Disney Through the Decades theme, Princess and Pirate theme, and the Disney Cruise Line 25th Anniversary theme. So exciting to think about, I know, but before you jump to any conclusions, don't forget this is just a survey. Disney is just asking guests what they think, maybe, maybe not, how you feel about this, but considering the fact that 3 new cruise ships are coming, I wouldn't be surprised if we see some of these, so let's dive into those details. The Walt Disney World at Sea theme bring the magic of the theme parks on board with activities representing each park at Walt Disney World Resort. Right off the bat, I am super confused. How is Disney going to do this? Maybe like a miniature park throughout the ship, or maybe like an entire hallway. Could be Main Street USA or a Pandora floating rock somewhere in the ship. My imagination starts soaring when I think about this, but the idea that they could bring parts of Walt Disney World to a cruise ship is astounding. Disney's Broadway at Sea theme, where runs of Disney's Broadway shows that tour across the country will be brought on board, offering unique shows to guests. Now, I personally feel like the shows we have on the Disney Cruise Line are spectacular, but I can imagine if you've been on 10 plus cruises, you're a Platinum Castaway Club member, maybe you feel like you want a different show, something special, not taking away anything, but something special for a specially themed cruise. This could be perfect for you. This one really grabbed my attention, the International Food and Wine theme. Prepare your taste buds for a cruise of worldly culinary delights. Special locations on board will be serving small plates and beverages from various countries. Now, I don't know about you, but I personally feel like the food on a Disney Cruise Line is the best I have ever had. Honestly, the best ever. And the idea that they are thinking about, only thinking, about having different booths around the Disney Cruise Line, like the International Food and Wine Festival, yes, 100% do it. Seriously, looking at me? Disney, do it. The Disney Music theme will include past Broadway singers and musicians on board to perform classic Disney songs in a live concert style show. It does sound similar to the Broadway theme, but keep in mind that is a Broadway show by Disney. These are singers and artists who are invited on board to play something. We don't know the details, but it does sound exciting. Disney's Animation themed, where your family can celebrate your love for Disney animated films from the past and present, from Steamboat Willie to Frozen. Now, this one does sound really cool, and if it does come true, I hope Disney has other things associated with it. Maybe an animator's drawing class, or maybe an example of the multi-plane camera in action. Just an idea. Next, we have the Heroes versus Villains theme. Embark on a cruise that seeks to find out, once and for all, who is the fairest of them all, heroes or villains. This one also really caught my attention. Can you imagine if you're on a Disney cruise and there's a subtle blue glow throughout half of the ship, and the other half is a very subtle red glow, and on half of the ship you have the villains, on the other half you have the heroes. This would be awesome. Next, we have the leader of the club himself, the Mickey Mouse themed cruise, where you can celebrate everyone's favorite mouse for a magical birthday extravaganza unlike any other. Now, you know I'm a big fan of the Big Cheese himself, so the idea of a Mickey Mouse themed cruise would be incredible. However, there's more to this one. If you read further, join your Disney pals on board to celebrate Mickey with limited time entertainment, character moments, and delicious birthday treats the entire family can enjoy together. It makes me wonder, birthday treats, are we only celebrating Mickey's birthday, or is this a longer engagement? Now keep in mind, this is just a survey, but I'm guessing that if they do have a birthday celebration for Mickey, let's imagine it's a birthday thing just for Mickey, I would imagine it would be more than one cruise itinerary. I think it would be probably several of them, and it would just be kind of a celebration over the course of the cruise. The next one is the Disney Through the Decades theme. Take your family on a cruise that celebrates the magic of Disney movies, both animated favorites and live-action classics. It does sound really exciting, however, it does sound very similar to the animation theme. They're both focused around those movies, and I'm wondering how they can bring that to the very next level. Something special that they can do on board. I know Disney can, and they probably are already thinking about this, but something extra special to celebrate that theme. The next one is the Disney Princess and Pirate theme, where you can gather your crew for a celebration of princesses and pirates on board, where your family can go from a royal tea party to a swashbuckling adventure filled with themed entertainment. Considering the fact that Disney already has a pirate night on many of the Disney cruises, I would imagine that they're gonna take this to the next level, and you're gonna see princess fireworks and pirate fireworks at the same time. It's going to be intense for sure. Last but definitely not least, it's the 25th anniversary theme. Join Disney Cruise Line in commemorating 25 years of sailing the high seas with a magical celebration. The theme for this style adventure is pretty self-explanatory, the 25th anniversary of the Disney Cruise Line. However, the details, we have no idea. Disney could do just about anything with this, but you can rest assured, if they do something like this, it would be for a very limited time, maybe just 1 year. So if you see this cruise and you really want to go on it, I would go on it right away. Don't wait, because I would imagine that something like this one would not stay around for long. These all sound extremely exciting, and I'm looking forward to seeing what Disney has in the future for us, but I'm left with two major questions. First and foremost, with Disney planning these new days at sea and different theming, are they planning on getting rid of the current offerings on the Disney Cruise Line, like the Marvel Day at Sea and Star Wars Day at Sea? I sure hope not. I really want to give them a try. The second question kind of follows the first one, and I'm only referring to the Star Wars and Marvel Day at Sea. I think the Very Merry Cruise and the Halloween on the High Seas, I don't think those are going anywhere. For those two themes, the Star Wars and Marvel, are they planning on keeping them on the current ships, or do you think they could move those to the new ships, or kind of shift them around and have them rotate which theme happen on which ship? I'm wondering what's going to go with what when the new ships come out. My guess is that Disney is planning on keeping the current fleet the way they have it right now. So you get the Marvel Day at Sea and Star Wars Day at Sea and all that great stuff. It sticks with the ships that they're on right now. And these new themes could be for the new ships that are coming out soon. That's my guess, but I don't know. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. On top of that, if you had to pick the top three of the themes that I mentioned, which would they be? I know it's a tough choice. It really is, and there are so many great options here, but only three. Pick three. Let me know in the comments as well. Now, if I had to choose one of those three, and this is extremely difficult, I'm gonna say the Food and Wine Festival cruise, the Walt Disney World cruise for sure, and either the Mickey Mouse or the Heroes and Villains. Oh, there's so many good ones. I don't know. There are a lot of great options. Probably Heroes and Villains. So, Food and Wine, Walt Disney World, Heroes and Villains. Those are my three. Let me know yours. Thank you so much for being a part of the magic with me. Until next time, have a magical day.